Hey, welcome back to the channel. Today we have seven fantastic C# tips and tricks to impress your friends at work. The last one is super spicy, which I wouldn't recommend using at work. You'll probably get in trouble. If there's anything you've actually learned in this video, I'd really appreciate it if you leave a comment. Let me know, help steer that future content. Let's go. First up is deconstructing a non-tuple object. Here we can see we have a tuple. If we want to deconstruct it and write it to the console, it looks a little bit like this. There you go. So what we might try to do is change this to a person class. But as you can see, the deconstruction no longer works. So what you need to do is into your person class, pop over into the body of the class here, and build a deconstruct function, which looks something like this: out string name, out int age, and then do name is name, age is age. Nope, with a capital A. Yeah, very good. Not app domain. And then the deconstruction works, and we can run the app with .net run. Banging. Which brings me to trick number two. You see, we're doing console.WriteLine everywhere. Well, you can do static using declarations. So do using static system.console and then delete console here. Boom, you can just do write line. Pretty good, eh? And the app should still work. Nice. Next up is switch expressions in property patterns. Imagine if we wanted to type put a message in the console like this. Message is hello. Write line, message. Very good. So far, so good. We know what this will do. It will say hello. That's a hello world. Now, if we wanted to change a message based on the person, we could do some if-else statements, or we could use a switch. So var message. Now, the fallback here is if it's neither of those, we can also do something like, and this will need to match both conditions for it to work. Hello, 56-year-old Karen. Obviously, when Karen turns 58, a couple of years later, it's going to say, hello, unknown person. That was switch expressions with property patterns. Next up then are pattern matching conditions in switch statements. So if we delete all this gumph, and if we want to actually change the message here based on the age and use a condition, we can do person P, when p.age is less than 20, message will be cannot drink in Japan yet, like so. We'll set the age to 19 or 18. We'll type .net run. Nope. Save it first here. Okay, cannot drink in Japan yet. Very good. Okay, and then obviously person P when P dot age greater than 60. We'll type okay, brilliant member of society, and increase the age way up. 67. Don't know, run. And those are conditions in switch statements. So we've gone back to our original sample here. If we wanted to not have a deconstruct method within our class, because we wanted to keep it nice and tidy, like a POCO, we could write a separate method, something along the lines of public static, get person info, and we'll pass in a person, like this, and we would want to return person.name and person.age, but we would need to change the method signature to be a string and an int, like this. And then we can just write get person info of the person, like so. And this is a method signature returning a deconstructed tuple here. Very nice. can try and run it. Don't run. There we go. All right, next up is setting a variable using a pointer. So memory, unsafe memory stuff. First thing we need to do is type the keyword unsafe. You need to make sure that allow unsafe blocks is in your CS proj. Otherwise this will not compile. We'll start shouting you. So if we save our Ted's age is the age from above, and then we can say that the pointer to Ted's age, is ampersand Ted's age. And if we write those two values to the console like this, we can do .NET run. We can see that Ted's age is 29, obviously. And this is the value of the pointer. This is the memory address that Ted's age currently is at. Now, if you want to change the age only using the pointer, we just need to do star pointer to Ted's age. And we can put something a little bit more realistic, like 32, which I think is more accurate. And then we can write Ted's age is now, so on. Oh, we need to save the project first, yeah? Come on. .NET run, Ted's age is now 32. The last magic trick, you should definitely not do at home, is swapping variables using XOR. So you can do var Ted's age is age, var Gary's age is 50. Like that. We can write them to the console like this. Gary's age. Now, we can just do this. Ted's age is XORed Gary's age. And this is how we swap two numbers without using a local variable. Gary's age there. Run it three times. We can print these two again. Like so, .NET run, and we have the two swapped ages. Don't do this at work.